Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials on any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then please write me at contact@devopschool.com. Thank you.
Step one is to select AMI. Are you seeing this
view? Yeah.
Okay, hang on. So you have to switch to launch configuration. You see this, right, sir?
Yeah. I switched that only. I switched and I went there. I couldn't find
You will fetch the launch configuration here if you have created it already.
No, I didn't create. That's what AMI is not able to select. That mentioned the AMI is not there. It's something else is there.
So before you are in the 37th step, right? Before that, let me see what you are doing. You are in load balancers. You are creating. You didn't create any launch configuration, right?
No. I've created only the load balancer.
Oh, this user is logged off. One second. Let me connect back again. I am logged off.
Okay.
This is done. Create load balancer done. You are in task number 3, create auto scaling groups, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you have to jump here. Basically, you have to create launch configuration. So let me come to here again. Here, when you are in auto scaling groups, right?
Yeah.
You say create a launch step. You create a launch configuration.
Launch. Only launch template. I see that Amazon image, but.
No. Here you have in launch template, and there is the switch to launch configuration. You see that?
Yeah. I switched that, and after that, what is the step?
After that, you create a launch configuration.
Okay.
So you, for creating that, you click on this. You will come to another window. So then you will select this launch configuration. Interface will look similar to that EC2 instance, but you are creating. Now in the step, you will select AMI. Amazon Linux AMI.
That's not listing here.
my marketplace. Start using launch templates. Let's see if this launch template has this.
Launch template has that, but finally I was getting error. We cannot create something. Then only I stopped. I don't know. Something mistake I did.
The steps are missing or what? No, right? Hang on. Amazon EC2 auto scaling is service better. Go here only. Okay, let's start from here. Create launch configuration. You have AMI.
Maybe they updated now that to use the template. They recommend to use the template.
But even then you're all facing some issue, right?
Yeah, even template I'm not able to create. I don't know.
Do we have any instances running, by the way?
No. In this account, no EC2 instance.
So you have created load balancer, you have done configuration of security settings, configure routing, you have done only on load balancer, right? Then you came to create auto. In EC2, you came here to create auto scaling routes. What do you have when you create launch template?
I was getting error, but I don't know why. I don't remember what error. I'm creating again. I'll just see.
Instance type.
Micro.
We'll select T2 micro maybe.
Yeah, micro and security group inventory app. And volume will not be the resource network advanced detail. IAM role, inventory app role. Shutdown, stop, termination.
Security group.
User data.
Yeah, you can do this, right? This is following that steps. Huh?
User data, but I got some error. Then I will try once.
So the name is mentioned on the top. You can do the name here. inventory app on.
You are not authorized to perform this operation. Encoded authorization failure message. Some authorization is not there. No, I cannot do like that. It is coming.
Okay, did you specify the IAM role?
Yeah.
IAM
inventory
role
app role. Inventory app role. Yeah, I given that. This is security group, and one more is the role is the IAM app role. Okay, in advanced details only. Okay, it's in the bottom here.
Inventory app, IAM,
first IAM. User data I gave, and while launching it is saying you are not authorized to perform this.
Okay, you're not authorized this operation and code authorized. Looks like the lab is, the resources in the lab might not have been ready when you started it. I will do one thing. I'll pre-warm the lab again.
Mm-hmm.
You can try that in some time, in 10 to 15 minutes. After 10 to 15 minutes, you can try the lab again.
Mm-hmm.
Let me sort of. So in that meantime, we will go ahead with the last module. Give me one second.
Yeah.
All right, I started the pre-warm of lab. In fact, I'll do it for two more labs, lab 5 and lab 6. We have to pre-warm that. And once I pre-warm it, it will be initializing all the resources which are required. And okay. Then we can revisit these labs again. So let's go to the content of the last slide.
So I have to end the lab, or what I have to do now?
Yeah, you should end the lab. You can again get back to the lab.
Okay. Yeah.
Let me start this. Why is this?
So how much time it will take to still 3 more labs have to complete? Huh?
Yeah, including these 3, and this presentation is just a wrap up. It is just maybe another 10 minutes will be more than enough.
Okay.
So in this wrap up, we just talk about what next steps you have, what other further steps, what you can do. So this is the learning path on architecting. We are targeting this certified solution architect associate, and you may also want to target professional. That's the next step on architecting. As a developer, if you ask about a developer, as a certified developer associate is one learning path. And after you maybe achieve this, you may want to target for certified DevOps engineer. A DevOps engineer professional is a sort of well-versed, thorough professional certification, which will give you exposure to a lot of AWS services on the developers oriented as well as SysOps oriented thing. And then AWS certified SysOps administrator is there, DevOps certified engineer. This is both the roles will sort of move to the next step on DevOps engineer professional. Either a certified developer or a certified SysOps can target this. So this is the mandatory requirement for doing this. And then some specialties, certified advanced networking specialty, certified big data specialty, and certified security specialty. These are some of the specialty certifications which will add good amount of credibility to your profile. Preparing for the exam, there is this exam details page on AWS content, associate exam detail. You might have received the student guide, right? So in that student guide, you will have these links available. And then self-paced labs, the labs similar to what we have done, you have self-paced labs in Quick Labs. You might want to take those labs as well. Then some recommended prerequisites for associate. 1 year of hands-on experience in designing available and cost-efficient fault-tolerant and scalable distributed systems on AWS. This is for any AWS associate certification. And then secondly, AWS training class on architecting on AWS. These are the two prerequisites for associate level certification. And for professional level certification, you will review the AWS Cloud Computing white papers in detail. There are a lot of white papers which have been published by the press on AWS, so that is helpful. And you have to have a sort of wider experience in using architecting solutions on AWS, both on-premise and AWS using AWS components. So this will give you a good amount of exposure in using these services on AWS. So with that, we have sort of come to an end of this course. The wrap-up is done. So I have already pre-warmed the labs for you. The labs are, you can wait for another 5 to 10 minutes and then start lab four. And then lab five also I have pre-warmed. If you started, it happens if the scripts are not executed before we start the lab, it might cause some unexpected steps. For that purpose, you have to select the right, you have to do the pre-warming on the labs. So lab four is, you have almost done partially, you can repeat that. Lab five and lab six, you can start. If you want to, lab six is again optional because that's more on serverless architecture in AWS management service. But serverless is not part of the exam, not much except that the Lambda is there. There are few questions on Lambda, but not predominantly. But you can still try the lab six. So these labs are available for you. You can just play around with these labs and get some understanding if you are interested. Okay. So with that, I will wind up this course. You can jump to labs on lab four, five, and six. And you can reach out to me if you have any questions. I'll ping my email address on this chat. You can reach out to me if you have any questions on these labs.
Okay. And what? Few questions like how will so how will the real exam, like the pattern will look like? It will be like very like a long descriptive, or it will be like
yeah, there will be questions, there will be few questions which will be long, like we had seen in some examples, right? So you have to read through the questions patiently, and there will be questions which will be a little long, but there are honestly telling you, there are a few questions which are having straightforward answers, as simple as asking a service for a given point and you answer it. There are a few things which are as straightforward as possible, and there are few things which are scenario based, and for those scenario based, you will have to read the question twice, thrice, you have to maybe highlight like what we have done in our examples, right? You might have to highlight them and read through it and then read between the lines as to what is expected. So that will help you eliminate and answer the questions easily. But all in all, the questions what we have seen, right? Similar questions are there on the exam also. Similar pattern. Where you will eliminate wrong answers and you will come down to the right answers. You will see similar pattern there.
Okay. So there are some for the CO2, some like additional courses they've included, like Fargate, AWS Fargate, and Global Accelerator, those things and all. And also AWS organizations. These topics.
Those are not directly in, required for this certification as such. Okay. You, where do you see that courses? Where are you seeing that?
No, I was googling through that sites, different sites, and I got this topics to go through for the exam.
So Fargate is where you have your containers. If you are spinning up your custom containers and you are working on container based or architectures, Fargate is one service which is useful. And what was the other thing you mentioned?
AWS organizations, I think.
AWS organizations. AWS organizations is where you can have multiple accounts. So you have this multiple accounts, right? Accounting, so we understand. You understand account. Yeah, you understand account, right? So similar to account, you may have a combination of multiple accounts in case. So there you will define something called as AWS organization. Let's say you are working for a company. So that company might have different accounts, right? Account for dev, account for production, account for something else. So how do they have interoperability between these accounts? So for that purpose, they will club this under one organization. So that is where organization principles come from.
Okay. Yeah. Just wanted to for the current exam pattern, there might be some more portions would have included. So I wanted to just check.
So this is the standard course which is coming from the AWS itself. Other than that, you may refer some other topics if of interest if you want, but this course is something which is of this content only.
Okay. Yeah, that's all I have questions, I think. Yeah,
then thanks for joining this, and I hope you had a good learning experience. You can always reach out to me even if you have any other questions on learning, on preparing, on any of the topics on AWS. Other than what you have done also, I may be assisting you if you want. I will have access to a lot of content on the resources and all. So you may just simply reach out. I can help you understand any topic if you have any question on. And finish these labs by end of today.
Okay.
And, that's it from my side.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much for time, and it is very good actually.
Nice with you have been a good audience all the while. Thank you.
Bye.
Please enroll our general membership for $399 plan to get access of all the parts.
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the $399 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.